Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar. In this video, we are going to set up Kibana on Kubernetes cluster. In previous video, we installed and configured the Elasticsearch on the Kubernetes cluster. Let's begin. We are going to use Helm chart to set up Kibana on Kubernetes cluster. This is the official Helm chart repository for the Kibana. We are going to modify this values.yaml file loading our Elasticsearch environment. This is my customized values.yaml file. This is address of Elasticsearch. How can you find the address of running Elasticsearch? Let's find out a list of Helm deployment in a elk namespace. Elasticsearch Helm deployment is running. Let's list down a list of ingress object in a elk namespace. Let's describe this ingress object. And you can see here, this ingress object is pointing to this Elasticsearch address. Pick up this URL and add here. I am running only one replica. I am going to use ingress for the Kibana. Enabled it. This is external URL for Kibana service. Leave the backend as a default. No TLS or SSL. That's all. In this file, I made a changes according my requirement. Go ahead and deploy the Helm chart for the Kibana dashboard. I uploaded my customized values.yaml file on a server. I am going to install Kibana dashboard in dedicated namespace called elk with name Kibana. Let's go ahead and execute. It has been completed. Let's verify. It is not ready yet. Let's look at the events. In the event, the health check is failing. It is throwing 503 error instead of 200 successful code. Let's look at the logs of this container. In the logs, we can see 200 success code. Let's pull down again Kibana pod. Yes, it is successfully running now. Let's try to access Kibana dashboard on the browser. Since I'm using the ingress controller, hence I can point kibana.domain.com to any Kubernetes node. Kibana dashboard is up and online. We can access Kibana dashboard on the browser. Index are empty because we haven't configured any kind of the logs with Elasticsearch. In next video, we are going to install and configure FluntD to store and analysis Kubernetes components related logs. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.